Hey guys, today we'll be learning how to handle zeros and quotients. Now when I say zeros and quotients, that means the amount of zeros in the dividend that you will have handled them. So what I'm going to say is, like, let's just take a look at an example. So if we have 480 divided by 4, first thing we're going to do is we're going to do simple division. So 4 goes into 4 one time, so 4 times 1 is 4. Then this will become 4 minus 4 is 0. We bring down the 8. So how many times does 4 go into 8? 2 times, right? So 4 times 2 would equal 8. Now we have 0 left, right? So this 0 is just part of the problem. Now let's take a look at this 0. Now we can't really do 0 and 4. We can't divide 0 by 4, right? So all we have to do, like, in simple ways, we're just going to take the 0 and whoop over here. We're gonna put it right here. That means that our quotient for 480 divided by 4 equals 120. Now, if you wanna check your answer, which is a good idea to do that, you can just go back and look at your quotient and multiply that by your divisor to get your dividend. If you get your dividend, that means your answer is correct. So if we go back and do 120 times 4, we know that any number by 0 would always equal 0. 4 times 2 is 8, and 4 times 1 is 4. And as you can see, 480 and 480 match up. That means that our answer, our quotient of 120 is correct. Let's take a look at another example that we can work with that has more zeros in it. So what if we have 150,000? That's a lot of zeros there. And we're dividing that by 5. So once again, first just look at the first number here. We're going to consider 1 here. We can't really do 1 divided by 5, right? So we're just going to put a 0 here, and then we're going to move on to the next digit. So 5 times 15. Now, if you wouldn't just do 5 times 5 here, we're going to merge them together, so we just connect them here. Now it just becomes 15. So 15, 5, how many times is 5 going to 15? 3 times. Because 5 times 3 is 15. So that would become a 0. So this here we can just separate this one. Now let's take a look at this 0. And let's bring down all of these here. So that means we have 4 zeros here. 1, 2, 3, 4. What are we going to do with these? Well, once again, we're just going to take these. So we're going to sort of go reverse. And rather than bringing these down, we're just going to put them up here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Amount of zeros that we have left, we're going to bring them up. That means our answer equals 30,000. If you're going to check it, I'm just going to go back here and you're going to do 30,000 times 5. 5 times 0 is 0, 5 times 0 once again is 0, and then again 0, and then 0. So we have 4 zeros, and 5 times 3 is 15. So we get 150,000 and 150,000, so that means they match up. So that was really easy, right? So you can always visit our website, and you will find more examples and step-by-step instructions on how to handle zeros and quotients. And we'll see you guys next time.